Let us learn how to create this beautiful animated process infographic, which is quite easy to create even though it looks quite complex. You can use this graphic not only to show the various steps in the process, but can also use it as a timeline or to represent any sequence of events. Let us learn how to create this beautiful graphic from scratch. But before that, I am Ramgopal from presentationprocess.com, the creator of comprehensive all-in-one PowerPoint bundle, a collection of more than 4,500 premium animated PowerPoint templates that help you create beautiful and engaging presentations in minutes. The first step is to go to AutoShapes Gallery, pick up this arrow right, and then draw an arrow that spans from one end to another. You can always increase the width to suit your requirements. The next step is to mark the events, which I'm going to do using a simple circle while holding the shift button. Let me draw a circle and let me place it over here. And then let me make three more copies by pressing Ctrl D, and let me place this over here and then hit Ctrl D again and again. Now I can move this first stop somewhere over here and then select all the other ones and ensure that they are all properly aligned with this one. So let me select this and say align middle. And then let me deselect this arrow and then let us distribute it horizontally. Now we have got everything properly placed. Then let me select the arrow as well and press Ctrl G to group it. Then let me go to Shape Effects, go to Preset, and I'm going to use this one called as Preset 10. Now you see instantly we are able to make this beautiful graphic. Now I need to make some small adjustments to be able to make this look a little better. So let me select this first 3D circle and then I'm going to change the material. Let me show you what I mean by that. Let me right click, go to Format Shape and go to Effects option, go to 3D Format. Let me select this first one and say the material, instead of it being translucent, is going to be warm matte. So that is the material. Let me do the same thing for the next one as well. Let me select this, hit F4. And that will replicate whatever action that we had done earlier. Select this F4, select this F4. Now, if you want, you can always change the color of these discs. In this case, I'm going to use a bright orange color. Can you see here? It really pops. Once again, let me select this and hit F4. So I'm able to apply all these colors. Then let me select this one that I see here and change it to white color. The arrow now looks a lot more interesting. Now, all I need to do is to write my numbers here and the corresponding text. Instead of showing you how to do it, I'm just going to pick up these elements that I've already created so I don't waste your time. And then let me come here and paste, and I can always adjust the position of these numbers here. Now, if you notice, this one has the largest font and the font size is 80. And as I make copies of this, I reduce the font size. You can see it is 72 and the next one is 66 and the next one is 60. And that is the increments by which it naturally reduces when you use this option called as decrease font size. Now, the reason why I reduce the fonts for these numbers is to show the difference in depth. You can see that the perspective clearly shows that it is bigger here and it is much smaller here. And therefore, the font size corresponds to the same thing. And of course, you can always label each of these events and then you can apply animation. I'm going to use a simple float-in animation for these numbers. So let us select float-in and then say float down, and this happens on click. Instead of it being for 1 second, let us reduce the duration to 0.5 seconds. Then the corresponding explanation is going to be fading in, and this happens after previous. Now let me move these animation events. So the previous animation and this happen one after another. So we have float in and then fade, float in, fade. So that is how it continues. When I go to slideshow, on a click, we have the first one, the second one, third one, and the fourth one shown like this. Now let me show you some creative examples taken from our comprehensive all-in-one PowerPoint bundle that showcase the power of creative custom animation in PowerPoint. Since we are talking about steps in the process, I want to show you just three examples. The first one shows three-step process. The first one comes on a click like this, and then a hand draws the attention to the second step and then to the third step. Next example is four key faces. On a click, we have the four elements shown like this. Then on a click, we show phase 1 and the corresponding explanation. Then phase 2 and the explanation. Phase 3 and the explanation. And phase 4 and its explanation. The last example is this one where we show 4 inputs to a process. We have the process shown here. On a click, we have the first element coming in and falling into the basket. And the explanation is shown here. And then we have the second element, explanation, third element and its explanation, and fourth element and its explanation. You will find a link to this product in the description box below the video. You can click on the link and explore more details about our comprehensive all-in-one PowerPoint bundle. In the meantime, do you want to learn some simple and creative PowerPoint ideas you can use in your next presentation? Then click on the link here to join our 5-day free email course called 25 Creative PowerPoint Ideas. These are simple, quick, and useful PowerPoint ideas I have not shared elsewhere. So go ahead, click on the link, join the course, and I will see you inside.